Choosing the right photo can really help you come out with a successful portrait. Choosing the wrong photo can really help sabotage your portrait. That's what we're going to be talking about in today's video. Hi, welcome to Paint Coach. I'm Chris Fornitero, here to help simplify oil painting so you can get better faster. As always, if you're liking the video, if you like the channel, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. You guys hitting that subscribe button, it really helps the channel grow. We're getting close to 10,000 followers. So please, if you like this channel, if you want to help it out, subscribing is a huge help. If you want to see what I'm painting on a daily basis, you can follow me on Instagram at Forza43. If you're looking for full painting video tutorials, I offer those on my Patreon page, which you can find a link to in the description below. Also down in the description, I have Amazon links to all of the materials that I suggest for beginner painters. Should I have my hat forward? Should I have my hat backwards? Let me know in the comment section. So recently, working with my online students, a problem has come to light. And that problem is knowing how to choose a good photo to paint from. And today I'm gonna specifically talk about portraits. If you want me to do another video on this about like landscapes or still lifes, let me know in the comment section. Doing a good portrait is already hard enough. And I see so many beginners choosing photos with elements that are making it even more difficult to paint. And the first element I'm gonna talk about is the lighting. You're not gonna wanna get a photo that has soft, even lighting. Now the thing is, you're gonna see a lot of pictures of people's faces with nice, soft, even lighting because it makes them look better. But remember, just because it makes a good photo doesn't mean it's gonna make a good painting. A lot of photographers use soft, even lighting because it makes you look better. It hides wrinkles better, it hides blemishes. It also gets rid of shadows, which for us as painters helps us define the shape and form of the face. When a face is lit soft and evenly, the value shifts are very, very subtle. And it's very difficult and takes a lot of experience to paint something with such subtle value shifts. Take this photo for example. When I put it in black and white, look at the difference between the darkest dark and the lightest light. They're pretty close together. So that means that you're gonna be working this whole portrait in this very small window on the value scale. Now it is possible to paint portraits that have soft, even lighting. It's just gonna take a greater understanding of value and also of facial anatomy. Since the photo isn't gonna be clearly giving you all the information you need to know about the structure of the face, you can fill in those gaps with what you know about facial anatomy. But if you're just starting out painting or new to this, you're not gonna know facial anatomy. And if you wanna paint a portrait without going and taking a bunch of facial anatomy classes, you're gonna wanna choose a photo that has a direct light source and has very distinct light and shadows. I think in the easiest to paint photos, the shadows are so clear and defined that you could pretty much just outline them on a piece of paper and you already got a pretty good likeness of the face. If you look to some old master's work, you'll see some great lighting for portraits. Now these guys didn't have photos or anything, but they knew how to light their subject to create highlights and shadows on the face that make it easy to define the form and the shape. So if you're taking your own photos, play around with where your light source is. If you have a light, you know, try setting it up in different areas around your subject. If you're using natural light from a window, rotate your subject so the light's coming at it at different angles and see which angle you like. Depending on the angle of the light, it's gonna create certain shadows, which is gonna create a different effect. Some can be more dramatic than others. Now I always try to avoid photos that use the flash. I have painted them before, but I just really prefer not to have a flash of even light coating the whole subject. All right, now the next thing to think about is having clear detail in your photo. Now, a lot of commissions that I get, people have like a certain photo that they want painted for one reason or another. It's a special photo or it's a photo they like. But a lot of time the problem is the person's so far away from the camera that I have to zoom in on the photo and I lose all the detail in the face. And you need that detail to see what's going on. Now, I'm not saying you need like a 4K photo where you can see every single little hair on the person, but you need to be able to make out certain details, especially with areas like the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. We're nailing certain angles and shapes can be the difference between the portrait turning out looking like the person or not. One little millimeter off here or there completely changed the look of the person and you don't have that likeness anymore. So if you have a photo where the details of the basic form and shape of the features isn't clear, it's going to be a lot more difficult to paint. All right, moving on to another thing is the tilt of the head. This gave me a lot of problems for a very long time. If you're painting a portrait and the subject's head is slightly tilted, if you don't nail that tilt right from the beginning, it's gonna throw off everything else. Your features are gonna be out of line, things aren't gonna line up, things are just gonna look weird when you get to the end of your painting. So if you choose to paint a photo of a person and they have a slight tilt, just know it's gonna be a little more difficult and it's something that you need to be aware of while you're painting. This doesn't mean don't paint heads that have a tilt in it, you know, always be challenging yourself and trying different things. Painting a portrait where the head is tilted a certain way can add a lot lot of expression and a lot of interest into a portrait. But just be aware of all the other things that come along with a tilted head. All right, now let's talk about color. When you have a bunch of different colored light sources hitting your subject, it's gonna make it a lot more difficult to paint because it's gonna be a lot harder to nail the value because you're juggling all these different colors and you gotta make sure all these colors are working in the right value. Now remember, value is how light or dark a color is. So just because you got the right color blue or the right color yellow, you gotta make sure that blue and that yellow are operating in the right value. So if you took a picture of your painting and put it in black and white, everything would look right. Color can be misleading when it comes to identifying value. So the more colors you have, the more difficult or complex it's gonna be to distinguish these values. So just be aware if you have like a subject with a really cool light on one side of its face, a really warm light on the other side, maybe it's got a white backlight, this or that, and it's creating all these different colors, it's gonna be more difficult to paint. Now again, I'm not saying don't try this. Having a portrait with a whole bunch of different colors can be really interesting and cool. It can also just be very difficult. All right, now let's talk about selfies. I've actually had a lot of commissions of people send me selfies or pictures taken with their phone paint. And you gotta be aware with, especially, you know, phone cameras and sometimes, you know, other cameras, if they have a lens that distorts the image. A lot of camera phones, the lens is really wide. So if you get close to the subject, it's going to distort a little bit. And the tricky thing is when you see a photo where it's distorted a little bit of a person, it really doesn't register with you because it's a photo. I don't know, it's some weird thing, but you don't really see the distortion as much. But once you paint that, even if you trace the photo exactly, when you paint that person, it's just gonna look weird. The proportions, just look, everything about the face is just gonna seem off because the photo was distorted. This is why if I do take photos on my phone, I try to use portrait mode, which gets rid of some distortion, or I make sure that I'm far away enough from the subject that this distortion effect doesn't happen. All right, now teeth. All right, what I have to say is pretty simple. Painting teeth is tough. That's it. So just know that if you want to paint teeth, go for it, practice at it, get better at it, make it so it's not difficult. A little tip for painting teeth is treat it like anything else. Squint down when you're looking at it, and if you see all the teeth kind of just as one big shape, paint it that way, at least for the beginning of the portrait. And just like anything else in the portrait, you can dial in the shape as you go. I think the trap people get into is they try and paint every single little tooth, which you might have to do sometimes, but a lot of times you might not have to. You'd be amazed at how little you can do to indicate the teeth and indicate the shape of the teeth. So just keep that in mind. You know, I feel like a lot of the times when you come to a part of a painting that's very difficult for you to paint, a lot of times the answer is just simplify it. At least for the beginning, simplify it to its most basic shape and value, and then push the detail slowly to where you like it or to where it's enough that it's reading how you want it to read. All right, now painting people that don't have hair, like painting bald people, is very tough. It's tough because you have to nail the shape of the top of the head exactly or it's gonna look weird. It's a very unforgiving shape. Hair is very forgiving. You don't have to nail the hair exactly. As long as it's kind of like generally the right shape, it's gonna work. But with a person with no hair, you have to get it exact. And a lot of times it's hard to see what's going on with the shape of the head because it is a sphere. Because different planes of the skull are facing different directions and are catching different light. And sometimes that's very hard to identify in a photo. A lot of times when I'm painting, I will flip my painting and my photo reference upside down so that I'm forced to just look at the shapes. And my mind isn't trying to fill in anything. I'm just seeing the shapes, I'm seeing the angles, I'm seeing the negative space, and I found that that really helps nail the shape. Now there is a little trick that I use sometimes with my photos to help make them easier to paint. I've talked a little bit about this in my other videos, but a lot of times I put my photo into Photoshop and I just use one of the basic paint filters to break the photo down into simple shapes. Now I'm sure you can do this on other photo filtering apps or programs. If anybody knows of any free ones of those, please let me know. Like a lot of my students have been asking me, they don't want to, you know, pay for Photoshop, you know, if this is the only part of Photoshop they're going to use. So if anybody out there knows a good photo filtering app that does a similar thing to this, please let me know in the comment section. But anyway, this is very helpful, but now be careful. Don't paint this exactly, you know, use this as a guide, like use this to see what's going on. Use this to identify the planes of the face. A lot of times I use this for the basic blocking out in the beginning stages of a portrait to make sure that I just get the general structure correct. But this helps because it simplifies things. It gets rid of detail. Like you're not seeing individual eyelashes. You're not seeing every little pore in the skin and every single little color shift. And it simplifies things. And in time, you will be able to do that yourself. So much of painting, no matter what you're painting, is simplifying a subject. We can't paint every single little detail. We have to see an image. We have to take it in. We have to identify the important parts, what makes that subject interesting, even if it's a landscape, a still life, a portrait, know the basic elements of what's creating that image and what's making it interesting, and be able to put that on a canvas. Because most people look at a scene, they look at a landscape, they look at a portrait, and they just see a jumbled mess of colors and values, and they don't know how to distinguish it. And I feel like that's a big part of what a painter does, is they take this visual assault of colors and values, and they organize it and present it in a way that a person can digest it and appreciate it. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Again, you can follow me on Instagram, see what I'm painting on a daily basis at Forza43. If you're looking for full painting video tutorials or private coaching, I offer that on my Patreon page, which is also linked below. I'm Chris Fornatero, here telling you to go get painting.
If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button. I also offer you this video and this video. They both will change your life forever. Just pick one. You can't go wrong.